In this video, I'm going to deploy the Azure Backup Agent. Hello everyone, my name is Travis and this is Seraltos. In my last video on Azure Backup, I showed you how to set up a recovery vault and backup servers in Azure. I'll add the link above. This video goes over the Microsoft Azure Recovery Services, or MARS agent, also known as the Azure Backup Agent. Before I begin, please take a second to subscribe and click the bell icon to get notifications of new content. Unlike Azure servers that can use the Recovery Backup extension, on-premises servers or servers in other cloud providers need an agent installed to backup to Azure Recovery Vault. The MARS agent is a backup agent installed as a service on a computer. The first question you may have, and the one I'm trying to answer, is why would you use the MARS agent? There are a few reasons. With the MARS agent, you can backup non-Azure servers, so servers on premises, physical or virtual, or in other cloud providers. With the agent, you can scope limited data for backups on Azure servers. Remember, Azure Backup extension backs up the entire server. The agent can be configured on the Azure server to backup a limited amount of data. You get greater recovery point objectives with the MARS agent. The Azure extension backs up once a day. The MARS agent can run 3 times a day. That provides a more granular RPO. With the MARS agent, you can backup a Microsoft Azure Backup server or System Center Data Protection Management server. The agent backs up the server workload to an Azure Recovery Vault. There are some things to be aware of, however. The MARS agent does not support application-aware backups. For that, you need to move to the Azure Backup Server or System Center Data Protection Manager solution. Also, the MARS agent only supports Windows OS, not Linux. Requirements for the agent include .NET 4.5 and PowerShell. The MARS agent also needs access to the URLs listed on the screen. The architecture looks like this. The agent is installed on the server, registers to the Recovery Services Vault, and backup jobs are scheduled in the agent. When the backup starts, the MARS agent creates a VSS snapshot. This is not application aware. The backup is only file system consistent. The agent creates a VHD file in the cache folder to store checksum data for the backup. The checksum data is used to identify changed data from the last time the backup was ran. The backup data goes directly to the Recovery Services Vault. Data is sent to the Recovery Vault compressed and encrypted to minimize and secure data transfer. On a recovery, the recovery point is mounted as a drive using iSCSI over a secure tunnel. Files from the recovery point can be accessed and copied from the mounted drive. I'm going to walk through installing the agent on a VM in my test network on-premises. This will work the same way for physical servers or servers in Azure or other cloud providers. If you want to follow along, you will need a Recovery Vault setup similar to my previous video. Let's get started with a demo. Buckle up everyone, it's demo time. Here I am logged into a server on-premises at my home in a closet, but that's not important. The first thing I'm going to do is download the agent. Here I am at the portal. I'm going to go into my resource vault. And as I probably mentioned before, if you want to follow along, you do need a recovery services vault. I set that up in a previous video. I'll add the link above someplace. You can go back and take a look at that if you want to follow along. Otherwise, I'm going to go into getting started backup. Here it's going to ask me what I want to do. So what kind of workload I'm backing up. And I'm going to do on-premises. And what do you want to back up? Now I'm going to do files and folder, and I want to do system state. But let's say I wanted to add bare metal into that. If I click that and prepare infrastructure, it's going to direct me to download and install the Azure Backup Server. Now I don't want that, and the reason why I did that is because I selected bare metal. Bare metal isn't an option with a backup agent. It's only an option with a backup server. So I don't actually want bare metal. What I wanted to show you is what you get when you click prepare infrastructure does depend on the questions you answer. And all I want is the backup agent, and that can only back up files and folders and system state. This is a two-step process. The first is download the agent. I'm going to run the agent install. I have two options for the installation. One is the installation folder and the other is the cache location. The installation folder, that's pretty self-explanatory. The cache location is where it's going to hold the VHD or the actual backup data. And as it states here, you need at least 5%, but you should have more available. So if this was located on a second drive, just make sure that you have enough room for that. I'm going to leave it as default and click Next. I don't have any proxy configuration, so I'll click Next again. It does a requirements check, and I have .NET 4.5 installed along with PowerShell. So next I'll click Install. Now it's done, I'm going to proceed to registration. It will ask for Vault credentials, and to get that, I need to come back to the portal. I'm going to check the box that I've already downloaded or using the latest Recovery Service Agent. This is going to download the Vault credentials that I'll use to register the agent with this Recovery Services Vault. And do note that this expires in 2 days. I'll just save that and come back to the agent. I'll click Browse, and that should be located in my Downloads folder. There it is. There's all my information, and I'll click Next. Next, in the encryption settings, it's going to ask me for a passphrase, and I'm not going to type one in, I'm just going to hit Generate Passphrase. Next, it'll ask me for a location to save that. Let's put it in Documents. Once I have that selected, I'll click Finish. I'll give it a couple minutes to finish. Okay, now it's finished. Let's go back and look at that passphrase that I have created. In Documents, here it is. Be sure to copy this information someplace safe. All data that gets backed up on the server will be backed up and encrypted with that passphrase. If you lose this passphrase, you will not be able to get that recovery data back. Microsoft doesn't have it. They don't keep it. This guarantees that your data is backed up and safe, that nobody's going to be able to take a look at it, but it also is absolutely needed to recover anything. Once this is done, I'll click Close. Here I am at the Microsoft Azure Backup Agent or MARS Agent, and now I'm ready to schedule some backups. So I do that by clicking Schedule Backup. This is going to walk me through a wizard that I can use to back up this server. So I'll click Next and Add Items. I'm going to add the system state. And I don't want to add the entire C drive. I'm just going to add users. You absolutely can select the C drive and select everything to back up. That's a more likely scenario in a production environment, but at this point, all I want is the data and users. I'm going to select an exclusion setting and add an exclusion. Let's just go down to C users. I don't want to back up the downloads file, so I'll click that. This is going to back up everything in C users except for the data in C users administrator download. And under subfolders, this is important because if I wanted to back up a subfolder in downloads, I could select no. But I don't. I want to select everything, so I'll select yes. And I'll click OK. I'll click Next. Now it's going to ask me how frequently to back up the system state. And I'm going to go with daily on this. And 11 p.m. is good. Notice you can only back up the system state once a day. Under retention policy, I only want to keep the weekly data for 4 weeks. And the way this is set up is it's going to keep the Sunday backup at 11 p.m. for 4 weeks. For daily retention, notice that you can't unselect that. I want to keep it for 14 days. So I'll have the daily at 10 p.m. and the backup that happens at 11 p.m. on Sunday for 4 weeks. If I wanted to keep a monthly retention, I could, but I'm not going to in this example. Next is the specify backup schedule for files and folders. This is set to daily by default. So we have one at 11 p.m. I'm going to select one at 5 a.m. And I'll say one at 1 p.m. Now the backup agent is going to back up 3 times a day, at 5 a.m., 1 p.m., and 11 p.m. I'll click Next, and now it asks for the schedule. So the first is the daily. It's asking how long it's going to keep all three backups, and I'm going to set this for 30 days. Next is the weekly retention policy. So the Sunday backup at 11 p.m. will be kept for 104 weeks. I'm going to change this to 6. Here are the backups on the last Saturday of the month at 11 o'clock. You can see I can change this or add these, but I'm not going to do that. And I'll keep that for 2 months. Yearly retention, it's the same deal. You can select which one, Sunday of the last week in March, or you can change that to whatever you want. Then select the backup time and the number of years for retention. I'm going to uncheck that though. I don't need yearly retentions. And I'll click Next. Here's an option for creating the initial backup. The default is to backup over the network, so that's just going to send all the data over the network. There's an option here, and I think it's listed as a limited preview, where I could backup using Databox, but I don't have that, so I'm going to leave it as automatic over the network. It's giving me the confirmation information, and I'll click Finish, and it's done. So I'll click Close. Now I have my backup policies in place. It'll backup at 11 p.m., 5 a.m., and 1 p.m. It's not uncommon to want to backup outside of a normal backup schedule, and you can do that by clicking Backup Now. So I'm going to select Files and Folders, and it's going to ask for a retention, so I'm going to backup until the 31st. Actually, let's just change that to the 18th. I'll click Next. You can see it's backing up the folder I had already selected when I set up the schedule. And I'll click Backup Now. It's going to walk through taking the snapshot of the volumes and then begin transferring data. And the job is complete. So I'm going to close this and come back to the portal and go into Backup. Now you can see I have three backup items. And if I go into Backup Items, it lists one Azure Virtual Machine and two Azure Backup Agents. And the two agents, I only have this installed on one server. You can see the protected server, but one agent for the C drive and one for system state. Now if I go into the C drive, you can see I already have a recovery point listed. So it's already showing that backup. I'm gonna pause here so we can let some of those scheduled backups occur, and I'll come back once that's finished. I'm back, and you can see we've got some backups that have finished. And I also have an error, so this was unexpected, but it's good because it lets us see some of the details we can get from the Azure Backup Agent. Here you can see all my backups from yesterday completed. One thing I'll point out is if we look at the detail, there's not much. We can see the detail of the last job, but even that is kind of limited. It just tells us how much, what was backed up and how much data transferred. And if we go into this error, it just says, look at the event logs for more detail. So I went to the event logs, and this is the only one I could find. It just says there was an error. So that's not very helpful. But I bring this up because there's another spot we can go. I'm going to go into my recovery services vault and backups. And here we can see we've got an error. A couple here monitoring as well as backup jobs. So let's take a look at this failed job. There's our server. And we can see that the status failed, what the start time was. So this is giving us a little bit more detail. And it tells us that it couldn't perform a backup because there's already a backup in progress. Now this is not uncommon for the first round of backups because it's backing up all the data. I wouldn't really expect it with a small amount, but point being that you can see the details on the failed job within the Azure portal. Not only can you see the failed job in the portal, but you could also alert on that. Let's go back into the vault and go to backup alerts and configure notifications. So I can turn this on, add my email address. Here I can get a notification per alert or an hourly digest. I can select the severity I want. So if I wanted to get critical and warning, I might want to do that per alert so I know when an error occurred. That's how you set up alerting in Azure Backup. I'm actually going to just discard this though. I don't need alerts for this. Next, I'm going to restore a file. To do that, I'm going to come back to the Microsoft Azure Backup Agent on the server and click on Recover Data. I'll select this server. We'll click Next. I'm going to recover an individual file or folder, and I'll select the volume. Then it'll ask what backup I want. So I'm going to go back to yesterday, the 1st at 1 p.m. and mount. This is going to take a couple minutes to run, but basically what it's doing is using the iSCSI service to mount a recover point as another drive on this machine. And then I'll be able to copy the files off that I need to recover. While that's working, let's go in to Documents. I'm just going to delete this file. It's showing the recovery volume is available. It's the D drive. And it also tells me that the availability time is limited. So let's go into my File Explorer. Here we can see I've got a new D drive. And remember, I'm only backing up user data. You may notice a little lag or delay when browsing the files on this recovery point, because it is going over the internet to pull that data down. So it all depends on internet connection. There's the file that I'm looking to recover. So I'm going to copy that. And then I'll go to the local documents and just paste it back. There we go. That's it to file recovery. Once I'm done, I'll click on mount. That's going to remove that drive. Over here, you can see that the last recovery has been updated for today. That's how you recover data from the Azure Backup Agent on a local machine. The last thing I'm going to do is uninstall the Backup Agent. In order to do that, the first thing I'm going to do is go into Backup Items. I'll go into my Azure Backup Agent and select one of these backup items with the server that I want to delete. And I'm going to click on this computer name. Notice a dot at the end. Before I do that, I'm going to copy that to the clipboard. I'll need that in a second. I'm going to go into that. Here I am at the server, and up here is an option to delete. I'm going to click that. Here I'm just going to paste that server name in, and I'm going to select a reason, and I'll just put in testing. And the very last option is to delete the recovery points. So this is confirming that I do not need this backup data anymore, that it's going to be gone. I'll never get it back, and I'm okay with that. Once I'm finished with that, I'll click delete. Now if I come back to my backup items, and I'll go into overview, here it only shows one server, and that's the Azure server that I have backed up. The last step is to uninstall the agent. So I'm going to come back to the server. We'll just close that. I'll go to Add Remove Programs, and this is just a simple uninstall. I'll select the Microsoft Azure Recovery Services agent and uninstall. All right, the uninstall is complete. So that is how you add a backup agent to a server, backup a server, schedule backups for the server, troubleshoot backups, do a recovery, and then remove the agent. Some parting thoughts on the Mars agent before I go. It is missing some features of an enterprise backup solution. Scheduling is configured on the client. That would be difficult to manage in large environments. There is no Linux agent or application consistent backup, both required for an enterprise backup solution. There is some central management and reporting through the portal, but that's limited to alerting and job status. Not included in the portal is the ability to configure multiple agents. With that said, the Azure Backup Agent may be sufficient for small organizations or remote sites with limited number of computers. It also augments Azure Backup on Azure servers, allowing for up to 3 backups a day and limiting the scope of the backup. I hope you found this useful. Don't forget to subscribe, and thanks for watching.